Good morning students, welcome back to you all in online teaching session and to the new academic year 2021 to 2022. I will be teaching you all the subject English. So dear students, today we are going to start with the beautiful poem What a Bird Thought. So dear students, before beginning with the poem, I would like to request you all to kindly get ready with your English textbook. So dear students, before beginning with the poem, let's have a glance on the index. Now your index is divided into four units: unit 1, unit 2, unit 3 and unit 4. Now in the beginning we'll start with the unit 1, poem 1, What a Bird Thought. So I request you all to kindly open your textbook page number 1. So students, let's start with the poem. Page number 1, unit 1, What a Bird Thought. So dear students, I request you all to kindly listen carefully. I'm just reading the poem first and then I will start with the explanation. I lived first in a little house and lived there very well. The world to me was small and round and made of pale blue shell. I lived next in a little nest, nor needed any other. I thought the world was made of straw and covered by my mother. One day I fluttered from the nest to see what I could find. I said, "The world is made of leaves. I have been very blind." At last, I flew beyond the tree and saw the sky so blue. Now how the world is really made, I cannot tell. Can you? So dear students, in this beautiful poem, the bird is narrating to us how it saw the world at different stages. So students, this poem is a narration by a bird. Here in this poem, the bird describes the experience of growing up and the way it sees the world. Here the bird narrating to us how it saw the world at different stages. So dear students, now I will be explaining you all the poem stanza wise. First, I will read the stanzas and accordingly I will explain you all. So I request you all to kindly pay attention properly. So students, now I will read the first stanza first and then I will explain you all the first stanza. I lived first in a little house and lived there very well. The world to me was small and round and made of pale blue shell. Now dear students, in the first stanza, the bird talks about how well it used to live in a little house. And that house was small and round. You can see in the image shown on your screen. That house was small and round and made up of pale blue shell. Pale blue means light blue in color. and that house was small and round. You can see in the image shown on your screen. That house was small and round and made up of pale blue shale. Pale blue means light blue in color. So dear students, now you can underline the word pale blue. Pale blue means light blue color. And shale. Now here the word shale refers to egg, which means the color of the egg was light blue, pale blue. And the shale refers to egg here. Understood with the first stanza? Very good. Now let's proceed to the second stanza. Now first I will read the second stanza. I lived next in a little nest, nor needed any other. I thought the world was made of straw and covered by my mother. So dear students, in second stanza, I lived next in a little nest, nor needed any other. So dear students, now when the bird came out from the egg, it started living in a little nest, nor needed any other. I thought the world was made of straw and covered by my mother. So dear students, when the bird came out from the egg, it started living in the little nest with its mother. So students, as the bird came out from the egg, it started living in the nest, and that nest was covered by its mother, and that nest was made up of straw. Now just underline the word straw. Straw means dried grass, dried grass. So dear students, since the bird was living in the nest, the bird thought that even this entire world is made up of straw, which means dried grass. Hope you have understood the second stanza. Now let's proceed towards the third stanza. One day I fluttered from the nest to see what I could find. I said, "The world is made of leaves. I have been very blind." So dear students, in the third stanza, one day I fluttered from the nest to see what I could find. So now here, as a bird grew older and struggled to fly. Now dear students, just underline the word fluttered. Fluttered means struggle to fly, tried to fly. So when the bird grew older and struggled to fly, to find out something means to explore the world. The bird wanted to explore the world. I said, "The world is made of leaves. I have been very blind." So dear students, as a bird struggled to fly, the bird noticed that the world was made up of green leaves and not of dried grass that surrounded the nest. So dear students, hope you have understood the third stanza. Now students, let's proceed towards the fourth stanza. At last I flew beyond the tree and saw the sky so blue. Now how the world is really made, I cannot tell, can you? So dear students, in the last stanza, in the fourth stanza, when bird has grown up and bird can fly extremely in the sky. So when bird flies in the sky beyond the tree, So the bird sees the vast blue sky, and the bird is unsure what the world is really made up of. So the bird tells us that at last I flew beyond the tree and saw the sky so blue. Now how the world is really made, I cannot tell. Can you? So bird is asking the question to us that when the bird has grown up and he can fly high very well in the sky, the bird is unsure what the world is really made of. And the bird wants to find out from us what the world is really like. So dear students, slowly the bird flew higher and went beyond the tree towards the blue sky. And the bird wants us to find that what the world is really like. Now dear student, I hope you have understood the poem very well. Now we'll see the rhyming words of the poem. Before finding the rhyming words of the poem, I will explain you all what is rhyming word, what is known as rhyming word. Now students, what is rhyme? A rhyme is when words sound similar. So rhyming words means what? When words sound similar. Now here also one poem is given with the help of examples. See, eat meat. It sounds similar. Yummy, tummy. It sounds similar. So they are known as rhyming words. Now let's see the rhyming words of the poem Don't Give Up. Now students, just come back to your page number 1 of your English textbook. We'll find the rhyming words from the poem What a Bird Thought. Now dear students, in first stanza, house and round, these are rhyming pairs? No, it doesn't sound similar. Well and shell, yes, this is a rhyming words. This is a pair of rhyming words. In second stanza, other and mother, this is another pair of rhyming words. In third stanza, find and blind. Okay, find and blind, this is another pair of rhyming words. In fourth stanza, blue and you. So total 4 pairs of rhyming words we got in the poem. Okay, each stanza 1 rhyming pair. So students, I hope you have understood today's. Students, here are some meanings. So these meanings we have learned in the poem. Now first, pale blue. Pale blue means light blue in color. Next, straw. Straw means dried up grass. Straw means what? Dried up grass. Next, flutter. Flutter means flying with flapping wings. What is the meaning of flutter? Flutter means fly with flapping wings. To fly. Flutter means to fly. Next is beyond. Beyond means far from, much further. Okay, beyond means far. So dear students, these total 4 meanings we have learned today in the poem What a Bird Thought. These meanings also I am sending you all through WhatsApp. Kindly note down these meanings in your 200 pages English notebook in good handwriting. We'll see you in the next lecture. Till that, stay connected. Stay safe.